हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर सिराज लखफैजी। आई वेलकम यू इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट फेलिंग टेस्ट। व्हाट इज दिस टेस्ट एंड व्हाट इज दिस सॉल्यूशंस? यू नो फेलिंग सॉल्यूशंस। द फेलिंग टेस्ट इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन टेस्ट used for the estimation or identification of reducing sugar and non-reducing sugar. This test by German chemist Fehling is often used to distinguish between functional group of ketone and carbohydrates that are water soluble. So objective of Fehling test: to detect the presence of carbohydrates in a solution, to distinguish between sugar reducers and non-reducers. So Fehling solutions, what is this? You know friend, Fehling test consists of a solution that is normally freshly prepared in laboratories. The solution initially occurs in the form of two different solutions known as Fehlings A and Fehlings B. Fehling A is a blue color, blue copper sulfate containing solution. Fehling B is a clear liquid consisting of potassium sodium tartrate, Roche's salt, and a powerful alkali, normally sodium hydroxide. Solution A and B are separately prepared and stored during the evaluations. In order to get the final Fehling solution, and that is deep blue, the two solutions are later combined in equal amounts. Copper 2 complex is deep blue ingredients. The tartrate tetraanion in the solution act as chelating agents. So friends, I will talk now procedures. What is the procedure? The process can be carried out as follows. Add the specimen to a sterile test tube. As a control, purified water should be retained in another tube. Fehling solution to be added to the tubes. It is best to hold the tubes in a water bath. Make observations and report whether any red precipitate grow occurs. Notably, the result is positive if the reddish brown precipitate is produced, whereas the result is negative if there is no sign of such type or such a transitions. So precaution: Fehling solution is often corrosive in nature. Therefore, wearing protective gear, including goggles and gloves, is always better. So reactions of Fehling test: the response between copper 2 ions and aldehyde is expressed in Fehling solution as aldehyde copper 2 plus 5OH minus give RCOO minus and Cu2O and plus 3H2. Once tartrate has been added, this aldehyde giving the copper complex with this and 5OH minus give RCU double minus cuprous oxide and this salt and 3H2. So friends, common uses of Fehling solution or Fehling test. There are some common uses of Fehling test. It is used to decide if an aldehyde or a ketone is carbonyl group. Aldehydes tend to become oxidized and create a positive outcome. Ketones do not react apart from alpha hydroxyketone. The Fehling test is also used as general test for monosaccharides, where aldose monosaccharide and ketose monosaccharide have a positive outcome. Apart from this, the Fehling test is used to assess the presence of glucose in the urine in the medical field. It helps to know whether or not the person is diabetic. Principal aim of the Fehling test: to differentiate between aldehyde and ketone group in a solution. A chemical reagent and Fehling reagent is used to allow the identification of sugar reductions in the test. Fehling reagent is composed of two solution A and solution B. Fehling A solution is aqueous solution of copper sulfate, whereas Fehling solution B is formed by alkaline sodium potassium tartrate. When both solutions are combined in equal amount and heated, the solutions B present in the reagent carries out the chelation activity. If the aldehyde or sugar molecule is the test tube solution, and then form a reddish brown chelation compound with filling reagents. The formation of this reddish brown precipitate is indicative of the presence of sugar reductions or aldehyde groups. The aim of performing the filling test is to detect sugar reduction in a solution. The new preparation of reagents is one precaution required for efficacy of this test. For the filling reagent test, sugars such as glucose, fructose and lactose yield positive results. So friends, frequently asked question, explain uses and limitation of filling solution test. The uses of filling solution: the filling test is used to differentiate between presence of aldehyde and ketones in carbohydrate, since in this test ketone sugar other than alpha hydroxy ketone do not react. In medical facility, filling test is conducted to detect the presence of glucose in urine, and this helps to define whether or not the patient has diabetes. Limitation of filling test: this test does not detect aromatic aldehyde. This reaction takes place only in alkaline atmosphere. The copper two ions would be stabilized and not easily oxidized in an acidic environment, so that reaction would fail. So define filling test. Filling test is chemical test which differentiate between reducing and non-reducing sugar. And this test can also be used to differentiate between carbohydrate and liquid carbohydrate in ketones functional community. Filling solution is still freshly formulated in lab. Initially it was created as two separate solutions, known as filling A and filling B. Is a bolus aqueous solution of pentahydrate crystal of copper 2 sulfate, while filling B is a transparent solution of tartrate of aqueous potassium sodium, also known as Roche salt, and a solid alkali, commonly sodium hydroxide. To get the final filling solution, which is deep blue color, equivalent amount of the two mixture are blended together. Aqueous tartrate ion from the dissolved Roche salt chelate to copper 2 plus ion from the dissolved copper sulfate crystal in this final mixture. As bidentate ligands, accompanying the diagram given, this tetracuprate complex. So friends, hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel. And thanks for watching.